It's Easter. There's hot cross buns galore left. What works really well with the spice, I think, salty, fatty, streaky bacon.
Marmalade. I wish you could smell that.
It's so complex, it's almost like Madeira. Bacon in the pan,
parchment on top, weigh it down. And then you get nice, flat, crispy.
Hot cross buns, they have mixed peel, sultanas, and an interesting selection of spice, including Chinese five spice. Very Nordic flavour. Sort of soapy. Doesn't make it sound very nice, does it? It's kind of...
Got one on the end of your nose.
Have I got one on the end of my nose? Still there? I picked my nose then, didn't it? What was it? The caraway seed. Great smell, that.
Scandinavian bakery smell.
Calm down, Lynn. Yep, come see. That's proper nice crispy. Toast the hot cross bun. Get it even hotter. And even crosser. Toast the hot cross bun in the bacon fat. I've got some fennel growing in the garden. I think we should try a tiny bit of that. Come on, come with me. Let's get the fronds.
I just love the smell of fennel.
It's outrageous, but I am going to butter this as well.
Marmalade. That marmalade.
Caraway. Bacon. Fennel tops. And we'll try just a tiny bit of chilli. Hold on, one last thing. When we made the hot cross buns, we glazed them. Marmalade, orange juice, and butter. It's gonna just look. I know I'm gonna get incredibly sticky fingers, but maybe that's part of the fun. Why I think it works. The fennel, aniseed and marmalade work so beautifully together. You've got the fatty saltiness of the bacon, acid in the marmalade. It's sensationally good. Make this with your leftover hot cross buns. Will you?
I'm sticking my hands out. Okay.
I'm glad they're sticky. Because it proves it.